Welcome to H2O's Freemium AI Cloud Environment. Today, we're going to walk through our Enterprise RAG agent and generation product, H2oGPTe, but I'm going to start by teaching you how you can get into the free trial environment yourself. So you will start by going to the website genai.h2o.ai, and you can see the various apps available, but we're going to focus on the RAG platform today, Enterprise H2oGPTe. When we click on this, we do have to log in to access the environment, but you can log in with your personal Gmail or GitHub account. And this is just to keep bots and other people from abusing the system. So I'll log in with my GitHub today. All right. And we have now accessed the environment. So today what we're going to do is actually chat with large language models on top of specific data. So I'll go ahead and click this little edit icon at the bottom and say that I want to create a new collection of data. I have the option to set any settings about my collection. I can name it. I know we're going to do the H2O website today. And for my more technical folks, you have control to set the embedding model that you would like. So in my case, the website I'm going to be using and the data I'm going to be using is in English. But if I know I'm going to do multilingual data or data that is not in English, I can switch this to BGEM3, for example, or other specific embedding models if I have a favorite one. I can also customize for more technical folks the chunk size or overlap for tokens, but for most use cases, using the default settings is going to be acceptable. And then for my use case, I'm using public data today, but let's say that you have data that has private customer information, but you want to use public large models like OpenAI's GPT-4 or another model. You might want to actually find any PII data when you're bringing it in and redact it. So you have full control to turn on guardrails and private data detection. And you can either make it so that that data will fail and the whole object won't come into the system, or it will just be redacted. A little black box will go over it. If you are using private models in your hosted environment, so you're running like H2O's Danube model or Llama 3.1, it might be okay to have private data because you're fully hosting those models. But if you were going to be using external large models, you might want to make sure that data is not sent to them. All right, so I'll use the default settings today to create my new collection. Once we've built our collection, we can add data to it. So we can upload from our local machine if we have PDFs or audio files or images that we want to be able to ask questions or generate content from. We can also bring in data from our favorite object storage or SharePoint, but I'm going to actually crawl a website. So we'll come here and I'll start just by saying the website that I want to crawl, which is H2O AI's website or homepage. I can optionally crawl this website. Now, I don't want to bring in a lot of data today. I just want to understand the marketing message on H2O's website, what the company is good at, and how we can help you. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the follow links. But if we wanted to bring in a certain number of pages or a full website, we absolutely could. Other settings we have access to, for every document we bring in, we can have an LLM automatically summarize the document for us. We can also have it automatically generate sample questions, questions that would be good to ask about the document. I won't do these today, but we have the ability to. And then again, for our average user, we're going to just click add and start loading in the data. But sometimes the experts want more fine-grained control. So we do have the ability to grab audio files and turn those into text. If you know what language is in those audio files and you don't want to leave it up to automatic detection, you can go ahead and choose the language of your choice. The default is that we will identify the language for you and transcribe it automatically, but you do have control over if you want. And same thing for OCR or the optical character recognition. So one of the things that's going to happen when we're bringing your data in is we're going to look at the images, we're going to extract the text from them and embed those into a vector database. And this is often done with OCR models. So if you would like to have the control over which model is used to do that, you absolutely can. Now, we'll go ahead and kick that off. H2O's GPTe platform comes with its own vector database. So we'll automatically take your document, put it into chunks, and save it as numeric embeddings that can be used for chatting. If you have your own favorite vector database, we can connect to them, but you don't have to have one. And then for special types of information, so not just text is needed, let's say you have a PDF that has a lot of images in it, we will automatically caption the image. So we'll take the image and send it to a vision model and say, explain to me in one or two sentences what's happening in this picture. But we'll also, when you're chatting, have the ability to send those images to a vision model that can extract information out of it. So we're supporting PDFs, URLs, audio files, text files, and some of each and images as well. So we'll go ahead and wait just a moment while our data is added into the system. We can see that this is the full website is probably 34 pages long, and we already have it fully extracted and embedded into our database here. So we're going to ask a question. First, we'll ask the question not on top of our data, but actually just to an LLM by itself. So we're going to pretend like we didn't just embed the website, and we'll just ask a generic question. What can H2O help customers with? And so this question is going to go to a large language model that has been trained on vast amounts of data, often from the internet, and it is not specified with any specific information from H2O. This is just a generic model. If we click this little usage box, we can see which model is used by default, and this is going to be the Claude 3 Haiku model. We do have full control to switch this, so if we would like to use a open source model like Mixtral or something else instead, we can, and there is a video explaining how the model is selected if that topic's interesting to you. So we have an overall answer, and we can see a lot of the answer here is about machine learning, AutoML, and predictive analytics. And this is totally a right answer, but in the last couple of years, H2O has been really pushing in the generative AI space and helping customers figure out how to use predictive and generative AI together. And this information is not in these large language models because it's a little bit newer. So we're going to now switch our generation approach, and we're going to say that we want to do retrieval-augmented generation. I'm going to actually just say automatic. It knows there's data there, so I will let it pick up the data for me. And I'll go ahead and ask the same question. How can H2O help customers? Or what can H2O help customers? So we can see now, instead of just sending that question to a large language model and giving us the answer, it's going to first take that question, send it to our vector database of embeddings, and find chunks of data that are related to this question, both semantically and then also literally. And in our case, we only have about 34 pages on this website, but there's often use cases where our customers will have thousands or tens of thousands of pages, legal documents, contracts from various customers or unions and partnerships where they want to get the answers. So we can do that embedding search in a very large space to find just the specific pieces of information that are related. And so now we have the answer on top of our data, and we can see that there's more of a focus on the newer things that H2O has been working on that's on our website. Things like generative AI, so building out RAG in agent use cases, document AI for extracting information out of your documents, and there is still a focus on that explainable and responsible AI. It's something we've been doing for the last 10 years, but you'll see there's more specific pertinent information to H2O because we ask these questions on top of the H2O website. So if you were to ask a large language model a random question about the legal process at your company, it's not going to know the answer. It will probably make one up and it could be a hallucination. But if you include your legal documents and then ask that question on top of those documents, you'll get a fact-based grounded answer. We can go ahead and click the references to actually see which parts of the website and the document were used to answer this question. So we can see that in information about on the website about the product we're looking at right now, GPTE, was used as an important part to answer the question and so forth. So these are actually the chunks and the text that was sent to the large language model. Now, if we want to see exactly what the model saw, we can click this LLM prompt button. And this will give us the system prompt. So we're just saying you're very good at question answering. And then we're saying we're going to give you some text and you're going to answer your question only using the text that we give you. And now we have the chunks from our website that were related to the question that I asked, what is H2O good at? And we can see a lot of tokens are sent to the large language model because there's a lot of text on the website related to that question. If we scroll all the way to the bottom, we finally see that we ask the model to respond with according to the information and then actually answer the question. So this RAG pipeline, taking your data, automatically embedding it, letting you ask questions and handling the model selection and so forth, is all handled automatically within the product. So we do hope you'll come to the free trial environment, add your own not private data, and get started with our large language models. Thanks.